Could you please expand a little bit more on the technique or approach, especially when the child is super sensitive? Meaning, for instance, even when you're trying to actually just explain that the child did something wrong in a nice way, in a very calm tone, but the child reacts adversely and should cry or starts to, you know, show emotions. How do you explain to that child that she or he did something wrong?
Thank you for your question. One thing important to remember that when we're interacting with the children, they really have different temperaments, different personalities. So, you know, and even among your own children, you probably have noticed this as well. So some children are much more sensitive, these kinds of things, and they can be easily, more easily emotionally overwhelmed. So again, you want to be very careful with what you are saying. So again, you want to be mindful with the language you're using. You're not, you know, leading them to feel and feeling criticized. Even in these other situations we're talking about, you don't want the child to feel that they're a bad person. Maybe they made bad mistakes, these kinds of things. So it's about trying to be empathetic. And also, it's about the whole journey of parenting is about, you know, guiding the child to make sense of the world, to help to guide the child. It's not about telling them, oh, that was wrong to push your little sister. It's about how do you stop and think about how you can make this a teaching moment. So, you know, you can ask them like, oh, what happened? And maybe they would be like, so what happened? Like, oh, so I saw there was some pushing. Yeah, so you could ask the parent, well, who pushed who first? And they'd be like, oh, I pushed. And how do you think that made her feel? And what could be different? So I think it's also, we often question as parents to label, this is bad, this isn't okay, and we give the judgment to the matter. Like, at this young age, they are not having their needs written even. So it's sort of a matter of like trying to take a perspective to make it a teachable moment. So again, if you can have this collaborative approach, I think it's ideal. So again, for the under 7, you are playing. So, you know, I'm managing all these kinds of things. Even if we may be frustrated, we may be busy, you are engaging in play, and then teaching, and then friending. So I think if we look at this advice, it is quite beneficial. And also, you may also have this dialogue also with the child. Maybe again, even if you try to approach it, they going through the world, they may have had some negative memories from the past. Maybe a teacher or some, you know, somebody has led them to feel shame. Another sort of practical advice is that, you know, instead of just look, it's really important to look at our own strengths and our children's strengths. So one thing you can do as a family, maybe you can have a whiteboard at the end of the day or on the weekend. You can sort of write, you know, what are the strengths you saw in each member? What are the happy memories that have happened? Those kinds of things. So when we give the feedback or you could draw, so it's sort of a matter of this, well, maybe if the child is sort of struggling, with some things or with their esteem. I mean, how we can really give that constructive feedback and tell them that, you know, this is really your strength, those kind of things. So also another technique is at the end of the day, before just passing, you know, into sleep and saying the dua, you can also do some gratitude exercises that, you know, today what I am I grateful for. And when you do that together with the child, maybe you can also, this is an opportunity to provide that empathy, that praise, that, you know, I'm really grateful today. And, you know, I know it didn't go as planned, but I'm really proud of how you handled it. So when you do those things, you are building that. You are building the open communication. But again, I know it's not so easy.